If you're an older sibling, you can definitely relate with Brad Carbuncle. But we're not talking about the Bradster today. Nope, we've already done that. Today, we're talking about his younger, more annoying brother, Tuck. Tuck Carbuncle is the pure representation of what it feels like to have a hyperactive, energetic, and troublesome younger sibling. He has black hair, dark-colored eyes, and usually wears a red shirt with a black collar and a black stripe in the middle, accompanied by blue jeans and black shoes. He is voiced by Audrey Wasilewski, who was also behind the voices of Misty, XJ7, and XJ8. She's also known for other supportive roles in shows such as Over the Garden Wall and The Loud House. Tuck was one of the very first characters seen in My Life as a Teenage Robot, appearing in It Came From Next Door alongside Brad, Jenny, and Dr. Wakeman. He is also the first person outside of the Wakeman household who has ever met Jenny. She offered him his baseball back after losing it in Wakeman's house. Tuck was extremely scared of Jenny and thought that she was dangerous. However, later on in the episode, after getting stuck with Jenny as she went to outer space to stop an asteroid from colliding with the Earth, his opinion of her totally changes, as he thinks she's completely awesome. Ever since then, Tuck and Jenny have become extremely close friends, as Jenny is almost immediately there to protect Tuck from any sort of harm. The bond between the two is extremely close throughout the show. Although we can't forget about his troublesome nature, Tuck has been known to be a pain, especially with Jenny around. Tuck can also be extremely annoying at times, in which his traits of being small and having an extremely young-sounding voice definitely help make the audience feel annoyed. A prime example of this is from the episode The Boy Who Cried Robot. During the entire episode, Tuck manipulates his friendship with Jenny to show off how cool of a friend she is to all the rest of his friends for popularity and to make his friends think he's cool. Even though Tuck may also be very young, he can be extremely cruel at times. The best example of this is in the episode Tuckered Out, in which he's a director for part of the episode, but acts like a complete dictator, bossing Jenny, Sheldon, Brad, and Dr. Wakeman around for his own benefit. But even if he may be very troublesome at times, he does usually end up learning his lesson, especially when he acts reckless. Good examples of this come from episodes Indestructible and A Pain in My Sidekick, which in both episodes, Tuck acts reckless and puts himself in harm's way to be popular and a crime fighter. But in the end of both of those episodes, he realizes being as reckless as he was is a really bad decision and learns from his actions. He has been incredibly mean in episodes like No Harmony with Melody, where he uncontrollably laughs at the notion of two girls fighting over Brad. Speaking of, Tuck can be way more rational than Brad sometimes, usually pointing out the obvious or trying to help Jenny or Brad out. Despite being a massive troublemaker at times, he's still one of Jenny's best friends throughout the show, and no matter how much trouble he causes, Jenny is always there to protect him. In fact, there have been times where Tuck actually saves Jenny. As an example, he saved her when she stripped all of her parts off in Victim of Fashion by using a mech made out of her body parts. Ever since the beginning, he's always been there, and without Tuck's reckless baseball incident, who knows what path Jenny could have gone down, or what could have happened? What are all of your thoughts on Tuck? Do you love him? Maybe you hate him? Tell us all about it in the comments below. If you're a fan of My Life as a Teenage Robot and want to talk about the show, check out our Discord. It's the most active part of the community as of today. I'd ask which character you'd like us to cover next, but with this video, we finally covered the main cast of the show. I hope you guys enjoyed the characterization series. We might cover some more recurring villains in the future, but I'm very happy with the series right now. With that said, I've been your narrator, YoshiFan2010. Thanks for watching!
Thanks for watching this video! If you enjoyed it, leave a rating. If you want to reach us, leave a comment. Or check out our other platforms. Links are in the description!